A central banker put it in quite such stark terms as Mervyn King, a 1930s style trade collapse. And he wants major economies a grand bargain on exchange rates, capital flows, realigning domestic demand. What do you think we might get out of this G20? Because you alluded to something earlier.
Well, there's no question that Mervyn King is right for another time or two in his life. The world is on a very dangerous precipice, and if we do continue with trade wars, that's going to be the end of the world economy. I hope that something comes out of it. I hope we don't have more protectionism. You see many countries already putting on capital controls, and if we don't solve this problem, it's finished. It's all over. I hope that something happens. I'm usually skeptical that something will come out of a G20 kind of meeting, but everybody is now so keen for something to happen that perhaps it will. Or maybe Mr. Stanley's right. Maybe we'll all go to Korea hoping for something to come out and nothing will. And then everything will drop precipitously the next day.
How precipitously, though, Jim? It's Nicole again in the States, and Lewis says or asks this: what do you think of the predictions that this bear market will go to 5,000 on the Dow?
Well, of course it can, Nicole. I have no idea. The problem with that prediction is if governments print a lot of money, it could go to 50,000 and we could all still be losing huge amounts of money because the money will be worthless. I'm skeptical that the American economy is getting much better. The central bank is making things worse. So 5,000 is not unbelievable or undoable. But the risk is, and the reason I don't have a lot of shorts is because I'm afraid banks are going to print a lot of money and then everything will go up.
I know you're not buying a lot, Jim. You said that. We have another question in just to ask your three best long investments that an average U.S. investor could join in on, perhaps an ETF that tracks, I should say, a commodity index that you like.
Well, I like my own commodity index, Michelle, but I'm not here to promote my commodity index. You can buy my book. You can buy a gift to my children or buy rice. You could buy rice. I'm very optimistic about rice. I'm optimistic about agriculture worldwide.